the Kentucky Derby, and wasting no time, it is Sinister Minister, and Sharp Humor comes on through in between horses. Toward the outside, Bluegrass Cat is there, keyed entry toward the rail, and here's that cavalry charge by us for the first time, and it's Sinister Minister, and keyed entry comes through on his inside. Sharp Humor runs third as they head for the turn, showing up is fourth, Barbaro's fifth in between horses. Lawyer Ron is sixth. Seaside Retreat is seventh. And then it's Bluegrass Cat, eighth toward the inside. Brother Derek, well out into the track. He's now running along in ninth position. AP Warrior is tenth. Point Determined is 11th toward the inside. Sweet Northern Saint, the favorite, is 12th and moving through in between horses. Bob and John is now 13th. Deputy Glitters is 14th. Private Bob, 15th. Steppenwolfer, 16th toward the inside. Flashy Bull is 17th. And then it's the Storm Treasure down toward the inside, running in 18th position. Cause to Believe is 19th. Jazzle, the stretch runner, is the last of them all. 46 seconds flat for the opening half mile, and it is indeed a grueling pace here, set by keyed entry. Sinister Minister is second as they approach the half mile pole going into that far turn. Sweet Northern Saint has picked his way through the pack. He's down on the inside fourth. Barbaro in the clear, poised as they move into the far turn, and he's moving up to be fourth now, showing up his fifth. Bluegrass Cat is sixth, and he's called on for more run as they round the far turn. There goes Sinister Minister. Three quarters in 10 and 4, and it's Sinister Minister, and here comes Barbaro. The undefeated Barbaro comes up on the outside, and he takes the lead as the field turns for home in the Kentucky Derby. Barbaro turns it on, and his stablemate showing up is second. Bluegrass Cat is third. Brother Derek putting in a late run on the far outside. Steppenwolfer is fifth, and Sweet Northern Saint sixth toward the rail, but they're coming to the finish, and it is all Barbaro in a sublime performance. He runs away from them all, and he has saved something left for the Preakness. Barbaro wins by 7. Bluegrass Cat was second. Steppenwolfer was third. Three-way photo for fourth. Jazzle, Brother Derek, and showing up. This was a no doubt about it winner.
Did let this horse go the way he did right there. They're getting him back in. No harm, no foul, it doesn't look like here.
Well, he's been on his toes all afternoon. Let's go back to Tom Durkin.
Once again, ready for the start of the 131st Preakness Stakes. Like now's a little fidgety in there. And they're off. Barbaro came away rather cleanly, and like now, and Garrett Gomez is intent on that lead. He sends him right from the beginning. And Sweet Northern Saint is going to run with him. Bernardini is away third. On the outside, Diabolic goes fourth. Barbaro, I believe he's being pulled up.
Tom Durkin, that's Barbaro, pulled up as they pass the stands for the first time. Michael Matz has made his way down from the grandstand, tending to the horse. When Edgar Prado sensed something was wrong, he pulled him up, and it appeared to be his right hind leg that was injured. You see him holding it up there, gingerly. And I guess things just weren't right with Barbaro all afternoon. They had to saddle him sort of on the fly, kept him walking. He was bouncing up and down in the warm-up, and as they made their way toward the starting gate, he broke through the gate, and then by the stands the first time they pulled him up. And I'm sure it's a nauseating feeling for all of us, but especially for his connections.
Well, it's the worst feeling there can be when that happens. And you know the way when a horse warms up like this, I didn't notice anything unusual. Sometimes they're touting you that they're feeling very, very good. Other times they're touting you that something is amiss. We can't talk to them. They can't talk to us. And obviously, this happened shortly after the start, and he took a bad step, but it's hard telling if this was something that had developed earlier today or just happened when he took a bad step. We're going to watch a replay coming out of the starting gate here. He gets away very, very cleanly, actually much better than he did in the Kentucky Derby. Sweet Northern Saint starts to come over a little bit there. No contact at all, and there's no apparent problem at all up to this point. He's in good position. Looks like Edgar is happy with where he's at. Right there, you see him take the bad step, and this is not a good injury here, and let's just hope that it's something that can be tended to in the proper way. But again, Edgar was confident with his position, and thank goodness that Edgar was on him. He's heads up. There's nobody better in the business, and he got him pulled up as quickly as possible. And I want to tell you, when you have an injury on a hind leg like this, it's so difficult. Edgar is actually the fourth leg for this horse when that happens. He's picking the horse up, and he is... Michael Matz immediately sees that there's a serious, serious problem, and it's just devastating. Edgar Prado right there, very, very emotional. With Peter Brett, the assistant trainer, this is a serious injury, and he's got the best in the business looking after him right now, so hopefully everything will be...